In this chapter, we will start the project using 2D site information, and then model the basic building envelope, such as creating a floor slab and adding some walls and columns to our project. While these are all very simple operations, they will underscore some important core design concepts. All Archicad building elements are real 3D objects. You might create a wall or slab in the floor plan view, but their 3D view is also at hand immediately and at any time. This enables users to view the project in its own 3D environment with instant real-time 3D feedback and to make better, more informed design decisions. Archicad enables the creation of a fully integrated project information database. Design development can be done in any view, plan, 3D views, etc. All other views will be automatically and immediately updated. No tedious iterative processes are required of the designer. This is the true power of the virtual building design concept. Create a new project by selecting the file, New, Command Option. In the appearing dialog, select Use a Template and make sure that the Archicad template is selected. Select the standard profile and click the New button. Choose Don't Save if the Save Changes dialog appears. A new project is created based on the standard template of Archicad. This template already contains layers, fills, materials, and composites to help you from the very beginning. Later on, you may also create your own template to fit your own design and office standards. The default project contains 3 stories. Let's change the default working units from millimeters to meters. This will not scale the model, but it does affect data input. Open Options, Project Preferences, Working Units. Set the model unit to meter and its decimals to 2. Click OK. Usually buildings are designed to physical locations, therefore orientation and geographical parameters provide the initial context of the design. Archicad is capable of importing various data formats to enable the architects to use it as a native building environment. For example, point clouds, Google Earth terrain, or simple DWG and DWF files. In this exercise, we will follow the most typical workflow of how architects and surveyors work together. We will import a DWG file to model the site. In Archicad, a dedicated workspace called Worksheet is available to manage all external 2D data. Open Navigator, Project Map, and right-click on the Worksheets item. Select New Independent Worksheet and set ID as W1 and name to Site. Click Create. The worksheet opens automatically. Now you can import the DWG data and place it into the project. There are 2 ways of using 2D data in the project, depending on whether the data may change or not. If you expect that the data may change during the project, use the XREF method. This way, there's a living connection between the original external file and the Archicad project, which ensures that in case the external file changes, you can simply update the content. If the data does not change during the full project lifecycle, you can also merge the content into the Archicad project. In this case, all elements will be converted into native Archicad elements and can be edited in the future. Now select File, External Content, Attach XREF. In the appearing dialog, click Browse at the top to locate the W1 Site DWG file. Click Open and click Skip to select font files if prompted. Set the options as visible on the screen. Click Attach, and then click the X sign, called Origin, in the project. In the upcoming DWG DXF Partial Open dialog, leave all layers checked, and finally click OK. Click any elements. The line work is selected with faded nodes. This means that it's not editable, because it's part of another file. We will use the lines as base geometry for our terrain mesh. Switch to the zero ground floor in the Navigator project map. Right-click the W1 site worksheet in the Navigator and choose Show as Trace Reference to select it as a traced view. Click the arrow next to the Trace and Reference button and choose Trace and Reference from the bottom of the list to open the Trace and Reference palette. Click the More Reference Options button and checkmark All Types to make sure that all element types are displayed as reference. Click Apply Settings to all references to ensure that the trace will behave the same way. Close the palette. If you still cannot see the lines, their layers may be hidden. Open the Layer Settings dialog by pressing Ctrl or Command plus L key combination, and scroll down in the list of layers. The layers of the XRefs are separated from the native Archicad layers. Click the eye icons to make them visible. Click OK to close this dialog. Activate the Mesh tool by clicking its icon in the toolbar so that it will be active, and then double-click the Mesh tool to open its Settings dialog. Set the mesh properties as follows. Mesh height, thickness 2.0 meters. Make sure the current zero ground floor story is selected as home story. Offset to home story. Elevation, minus 0.1 meters under the project zero level. Select solid body as structure. Set soil as building material. Uncheck cover fills in the floor plan and section panel. Set LS grass green as top material and LS earth as side and bottom materials by clicking the Override Surfaces buttons. Select all ridges sharp. Tags and categories. If you are going to communicate your design to any engineers who work with 3D applications, you will have to fill in these fields so the external application can recognize them properly. Set ID as Mesh 001. Set Structural Function as Non-Load-Bearing Element. And set Position as Exterior. Click OK. Select the Rectangular Geometry method in the info box and click the two opposite points of the site rectangle to create a mesh. Select the mesh by holding the Shift key and then clicking it. Please make sure that the Mesh tool is selected or active in the toolbox. Space-click the curved level lines one by one to add them to the mesh. By holding down the spacebar on your keyboard and clicking the lines with the mouse cursor. Select Fit to User Ridges in the New Mesh Points dialog. To set the height of the points of the mesh that are on the same height level, select the mesh and click on a node of the second line from the right, the line in the middle. When the PET palette appears, click Elevate Mesh Point. Set height to 0.50 and check the Apply to All checkbox so that all nodes on this line will be elevated to the same height. Click OK. Repeat this action with the line on the right. In this case, set the elevate mesh point to 1.00. Now, elevate the two corners on the right one by one. Click on the upper corner. Select elevate mesh point again, and set 1.00 as the height, but leave the apply to all checkbox unchecked, otherwise all points of the rectangle would rise. Repeat this with the corner below. The result should look like the one presented on the screen. Select the mesh, right-click, and select Show Selection Marquee in 3D to check its shape. Click on the Fit in Window icon if it is not visible. Go to View and click Editing Plane Display to turn off the editing plane.